repeat after me. This is the day that the Lord has made. Amen. God bless you. Amen. I'll put a tag on this text for a few moments with your prayers. I want to use as a subject from which to preach, a day in the making. A day in the making. I've come to the conclusion that God can do a lot with a day. In fact, a day is such an ingenious concept that man has found many ways to capitalize off of the value that surrounds a day. Because although our intentions may many times seem harmless, we lay claim to some days that denote less of what the Lord did and more of what we branded it to be. We've got New Year's Day to signify a good start of the year. We have Valentine's Day to make up for the love we didn't give all year long. We've got Memorial Day. We've got Labor Day. We've got Veterans Day. And we got Columbus Day. Everybody's got a birthday. We love any holiday. Teachers even got a planning day. Now we do thank God for payday. Say amen if you understand. And we encourage our loved ones as we leave for work in the morning to have a good day. And we, by way of sentiment, then ask upon return, how was your day? Because we all realize that a lot can happen in a day. It arrives to God and you can remember a day when things didn't quite go your way. The kids don't want to wake up. The car wouldn't start. The debit card is dysfunctional. The traffic tried your patience. And folk turned up by the time you walked into the office on a job that you don't get much joy about in the first place. And that's just the beginning of a day that it's safe to say that stuff can start out the wrong way, leaving you weary, worn, and sad. But when you know the one who made the day, then what a difference a day makes. I wish I had a witness. When you know the one responsible for dividing, designating morning, afternoon, and evening, you understand that a miracle can come by midnight. And once the miracle comes by midnight, you can testify what a difference a day makes. I wish I had a witness. Folk here at Friendship ought to understand that statement real well, because around 8 years ago today, the Lord sent a man named Day. Huh? Lord sent a man named Day to make a difference, and what a difference a day makes. I give God the glory. Even if you ain't amped up about it in here, I know some folks throughout 4th District who will help me say, what a difference a day makes. What a difference a day makes. He ain't the same all the time with everything. He's innovative and outgoing and still embraces the Baptist institution. He's unordinary and ever evolving, but his attitude ain't out the box. Do I have a witness here? Because I know some brothers who are bishops, but they don't want to be bothered with me. Holler if you hear me. I got some partners who think they pastoring, but they really just good pulpiteers. Because you got to be able to tell it to them and then take it with them. You got to be able to say it and then go see the sick and shut in. You got a good truth, but can you teach it to me first? And if I know anything about this clergyman they call Lacoya, he encompasses all these credentials because he keeps it all about Jesus Christ. If you'll permit me a few minutes, I think a parallel of the person passed today against the biblical passage regarding this day can bring some interesting perspective. I think one, what we can see is that the person passed today is a preacher and the passage is a pronouncement. Lord, deliver me from preachers who won't preach the passage because they try to be political. Do I have a witness? I discovered that if you've really been called to preach, you can't be politically correct when it comes to preaching Christ. Because his word is uncompromising, his way is unprecedented, and his position ain't up for re-election. And this preacher they call Day has proven that he ain't no pushover when it comes to preaching and proclaiming the word with power with what the passage has to say. And this passage pertaining to a day, although a pronouncement, has to be pronounced from a preacher with power. power if it's going to penetrate. And it can't be pronounced with power if the preacher ain't been through nothing. Talk to me. And if you ain't never had to preach while you in pain, if you ain't never had to keep your cool through a chaotic church conference, if you ain't never had to hear from the doctor that your wife ain't well while your child is in trouble and the church still ain't transitioning, then your pronouncement of the passage might sound puny. But if your yesterdays have ever yielded some pain, you found out real quick the pain produces power. Wish I had a witness up in here. Anybody ever had some yesterdays you thought you wouldn't make it? Some yesterdays where you didn't know what was going to happen? Yesterdays that hurt so bad you couldn't leave the bed. But thanks be to God that something happened between yesterday and today. And you discover that God will possess you and then he'll progress you. I'm preaching. Y'all just didn't hear that thing. God will take you up and he'll fill you up and be a resident in you, then walk right beside you. God will get in your stuff and then help you stand, because the more I appreciate where I was, the more I can celebrate where I am. Huh? This is the day that the Lord has made. This is the day, which leads me to my next point. I ain't gonna be long. The person past the day is a prophet. And the passage for friendship is prophetic. The Bible reminds us in Proverbs that where there is no vision, people perish. Certainly for those who sit in this sanctuary every Sunday, you experience something now that is new from 9 years ago. The preaching is not the same. The order of service may be somewhat different, and there's a sweet spirit in this place. And the Lord had to do something inside his servant first for us to see this day. So when the psalmist states that this is the day is already identified by the word. I don't know about you, but that comforts me, because no matter how much I mess up or go wrong, the word reminds me that I'm still a child of God. Huh? What I've done ain't who I am. Where I've gone ain't where I go. And in spite of folk who try to misidentify me, I got news for you. God made me, so don't mistake me. I'm right now what God said I was that day. I'm presently who God said I was. That's why you can get glad about this day, because it identifies itself as offspring of the manufacturer. This is the day that the Lord has made. You do know that God made this day, don't you? And if God made it, that means he can maneuver it any way he wants. In other words, if they work it out right in the beginning, I got a God who'll come through in the end. If you find yourself down in the first quarter, kick a field goal in the fourth quarter. And it'll always be. Huh? You ever been down in a fourth quarter situation and the clock went zero with no time left? I'm a witness that God will make it good. He'll come through in the last second when the clock strikes zero. I wish I had a witness up in there for folk who had fourth quarter situations. You didn't have no money. You didn't have no food. You didn't have nobody, but this is the day. This is the day. There's nothing that happens in this day that he's not aware of. There's nothing we see in this day and he's not made a decision on already. And if the day has been identified, God ought to be glorified. Huh? Finally, what I observe is that the person past the day is poignant and the passage is possessive. Anybody who's ever met this preacher can co-sign on the fact that he's not pretentious. He gets straight to the point. He's direct and he's decisive. His word is strong and he's straightforward. He's absolute and owns what he's been assigned to. And that's precisely what the text presents. It owns the idea that this day belongs to the Lord. The word is exact and self-evident. The word is succinct without supposition. It doesn't say could be the day or would be the day. It doesn't elude, imply, or infer. There's no other option for the day. Even if the day didn't want to do statute has mandated that they have no choice, because it is the day that the Lord has made. Even if the day wanted to debate about it, it wouldn't matter, because it is the day that the Lord has made. Even if the day didn't want to abide by the rules, it wouldn't make a difference, because it is the day that the Lord has made, because what God said is can't be interfered with. Understands the one who said it is indisputable. The order that's been given is undeniable, because the word is has to answer to the omniscient. This is the day. So if the word is and the object of the sentence day have to answer to the Almighty, what makes us think that what happens within our day, God can't turn it around and make it work? If the day has to answer to God, and the word has to answer to God, then anything we go through and ask God for, God will make a way if it lines up with God's word. God is a good God who will do just what he said. I wish I had some witnesses up in here, and I don't know about you, I can't speak for you, but all I know is thanks be to God for where he's brought me from. He's brought me from a mighty long way. A little bit better because the Lord is with me. I can sing a little bit better because the Lord is in my step. I can walk on a little bit better because the Holy Ghost is with me. Anything I do it because the Lord is on my side. I wish I had some witnesses in here who understood the thanks be to God. He can do it in the day. He can do it in the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. I can witness that before the day is done, God can do something. That's what I like about Pastor Day. He knows how to hand stuff over to God and let God do something with it. Because it's evident that Pastor Day knows how to pray. God gave him a wife. That's a pretty day. God blessed him with children. Those are young days. Raised by good parents. Those are proud days. Got a lot of family. That's what you call a lot of days. And if the day in the text did like Dave the pastor, then the problems within the day would be dealt with. Because I discovered that God got experience, y'all, with days. Anybody know that God can do something in a day? He started in Genesis 1 when he divided the light from darkness, and God called the light day. He said in Zechariah, and the Lord their God will see them in that day. He said in Micah, I will assemble the lame and outcast in that day. Reminded Jeremiah, I will break yokes and tear off bonds. That's good news of distress on that great day. I declare, if ever you lose your way, God knows how to handle a day. God knows how to do something with a day. He'll keep you warm on a cold day. He'll keep you cool on a hot day. Keep you covered on a rainy day. He'll give you one more sunny day. That's why you better choose you this day, so you'll have a place in heaven to stay. Because it's going down on judgment day. But Jesus made a way one Friday on a hill called Calvary. Died one Friday. Stayed dead on Saturday. But early on the third day, he got up with all power. Is there anybody here who got third day theology? You know about getting up from somewhere. You know how to get up in God. You know how to get up from dark days. Get up from sad days. Get up from mad days. And now you got glad days. Because every day is a day of thanksgiving. Every day, Lord's been blessing me. He's been so good to me. Is there